These Asian guys have good salaries, they're physically fit, they're well-traveled, but they still need more help on their dating app profile. Hopefully we say something that can help them.
You know, I did everything my mom told me to do, but the match is still not coming as easy as I wanted. What's going on? We got to talk about it because we have five different profiles that were asking the internet for advice on their Hinge profiles, on their dating online profiles, and basically we compiled some of the advice that the message boards gave them, as well as our own hot takes. So make sure you like, subscribe, turn on your notifications, see if you agree, disagree, or have any additional advice.
All right, David, real quick, we're giving advice on the internet. What does any, do you need qualifications to give dating app advice?
Yes and no. I mean, I think anybody can analyze something, but obviously it helps if you've been through the real life reps yourself. And obviously for us, we've probably been in the apps, traveled a lot, just been around, seen some things.
Yeah, dated some people. Okay, so we've thought about this, and I do want to also talk about like their situation and expectations, because I think that's a big part of the dating apps as well. So let's get into profile number one.
Ander, we've got a buff quantitative researcher. He's Canadian, but he's living in Chicago. I'm assuming possibly in a PhD program.
Okay.
So he's a 26-year-old male. First off, here's his first photo. Boom. Here's his second photo. He says, I want to enter the Chicago Sings Karaoke Contest. Here's right here immediately. He probably should record himself singing in the vocal note.
Right. Show some talent. I will also say, I mean, moving on to this next first picture, good smile. Second picture, he's buff. He's buff. Hey, good job for you. You're probably, I don't know how tall he is, but is he 5'10"? He looks roughly anywhere from 5'8 to 5'10".
He's like super buff. He looks like literally a pro rock climber tier buff.
Yeah, probably could have taken that photo somewhere else instead of the locker room. But anyways, let's continue.
Photo with a Shiba Inu. He's got a dog. Here he is feeding some sort of deer. I believe he's eating yakitori at some sort of Japanese spot, possibly in Japan, because he has the Mario Kart go-karts thing, which is very popular in Tokyo.
Got it.
Here's the first piece of advice that the internet gave him, Andrew. We're going to rank the advice. They said, please get a haircut, maybe something more stylish from a Korean barber that specializes in K-pop styles. You seem like you like more styles from Asia.
Makes sense.
This girl said, take open to short out of your profile because sometimes that makes girls have a bad image of some guy who says open to short.
Oh, he was saying I'm open to short girls?
No, open to short term.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah, I could see not needing to put that.
Someone said, maybe too much nice guy vibes. You have the buffness to play the bad boy role.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it depends though, because to pull off the bad boy thing, if you don't have that streak in you, it could be hard, right? Somebody said, you look like a fintech bro, which is the nerdier version of a finance bro. I would recommend to him maybe look more like a finance bro, even if he's a fintech quant. You know what I mean? Like go more for the chat. You know, we'll pop up this meme right here. Somebody said, if you are Asian in Chicago, good luck, bro, because so many girls in the Midwest are automatically going to filter you out, especially because your vibe seems super duper Asian.
Right. Overall, I'm going to say straight up, he's not in bad shape. I mean, overall, like, he's got some good photos and
he's got some good cards.
I think he's working with a good amount, you know, so I don't think he's in like dire need. I think it's really going to be, yeah, a haircut, maybe a couple different, replace a couple of the photos. But ultimately, man, like, I think it's his expectations, because like, if he's open to short, he probably wants to hook up with girls, I'm assuming. Like, he wants to have that ability and that option. So then I think he's going to have to play up a little bit more of that bad boy image and then go for numbers, especially in Chicago as an Asian guy.
It's true that a lot of girls in Chicago are not immediately looking for a Canada-style Asian guy, even though he's tall and buff.
Yeah. I would say remove that picture with the Shiba Inu dog, because it kind of makes him look... I think he could just roll with the bad boy pictures, but in the profile reveal that he's kind of nerdy.
I would just go to a hockey game or a football game or a baseball game and just maybe try to get a few nerdy white chicks that want to get with a buff Asian dude too. Whether he's into those things or not, just play that angle. You're in like the heartland of America. That's what they respond to. But obviously, not bad cards at all. I will say this. I noticed guys from Canada feel a lot more comfortable being like almost like a, you know, like a buff fob style than in America. In America, he probably wouldn't have developed like this in terms of subculture. Moving on, number two, Andrew, we've got what I like to call a rich old money world traveler Chinese Indonesian guy. because he's taking this first photo right here. Okay, he looks like he's going after the Henry Golding. Like, yeah, let me meet you, my ama.
We're
colonial royalty.
Well, that's a lake in somewhere in Europe. That looks cool. I mean, that's a cool photo.
Right.
Like, that's a nice photo.
His two truths and a lie are, I was a yoga instructor. I went to another country for a Hinge date. I've been called a sweetheart by a member of the royal family. Like I said, again, he's playing into that whole old money, colonial Indochina aristocracy thing. He's in the Swiss Alps. He's getting beer in Deutschland, I think, because he says he speaks German. Anyway, let's just get into his profile, what the internet said. Andrew, they said, why are you mentioning bidets? In his prompt, he talks about on his Hinge profile how much he likes aqua bidets.
We're trying to get his butt la.
That's crazy.
No, buy a date. That's what he wants. He's saying, you saying that. I mean, that's...
Well, it's to refer to... I don't even want to say the word, but posterior stimulation, enjoying it, is an interesting angle to go for.
No, I'm sure
for a guy who looks like he's trying to project old wealth from the 1920s.
Yeah, maybe that's his fetish. But also, I mean, yeah, of course people enjoy it low-key, but you don't need to talk about it anyways.
He looks like a nice dude. Andrew, would you agree? He looks like he's trying to go for more husband material to a girl who also is into old money lifestyle.
Well-off husband material, I think so. He does definitely looks like if you... No people with money. He looks like he got money. I don't know how much money he has.
But he looks like he has money from a colonized European country that is even stuck more in the colonial days than modern Europe.
Yeah, he looks comfortable in his wealth. He's not trying to flaunt it. Obviously, that gives more old money vibes.
Somebody said, why would you say you went to another country just for a Hinge date? Doesn't that sound really desperate to girls?
Yeah, I would say so.
It's unclear. He also had, I believe, long-term and short-term checked. So it's like unclear what he's going for. Someone said, are you bookish or outdoorsy? I think actually those just fit into his old money lifestyle that he's trying to portray, like almost McLaren in New Zealand from like 1935 or whatever. And ultimately, I'll say this. If this guy's in America, it just feels like he's being informed by a cultural sphere that's not only from Europe, but from a version of Europe that doesn't even exist anymore.
Yeah.
So I guess my whole thing is like, it's not a terrible profile, but it just doesn't fit with like, I guess a cultural sphere that I think a lot of American women are going to understand.
Right. I would say it highly appeals to a Asian woman from Asia that has spent time in Europe. I think that's really who's going to like his profile.
You mean maybe speaks French or German or Swiss?
Dude, he looks like he's more of a wine guy than a shots guy for sure, obviously. So I think that it looks like that he might have gone to like a European school at some point in his life, you know? He looks very Euro. That's what I mean. So I think that does appeal to a number. But if you're trying to, let's say he's in America and he's trying to get hookups, then yes, that is a certain vibe that you would want to tune your profile to. I got to see you without your shirt, bro.
But
where's your shirtless photo?
Also, I'll say this. This is an interesting aside. Sometimes colonial Southeast Asia is more old school than the actual countries that colonized Southeast Asia is, because they kept going, but you got imported an ancient version, aristocratic version of Europe.
Yeah. What a lot of people don't realize is like, it's okay to post a photo where you're trying to look cool and you actually look cool in, even though people know it's intentional. I think some people try to play the natural card and they're like, no, I want it to look natural. I don't want to look like I'm trying too hard. If it actually is a good photo, it's okay. We get it. You're marketing yourself on the dating apps. That's what you're supposed to do.
Right. You mean like an ultra delicious piece of food from like dig in ad or something.
Yeah, like you don't want to look cringe in the photo, but if the photo is literally a good photo and it took a few shots to take it and it looks cool, like I think the lake photo when it popping out of the lake swimming, hello, I'm swimming out of the lake. How are you, ladies? Like he looks good in that. But there's some other photos where I was like, you probably could have taken that out.
Right. Moving on to profile number three, Andrew. We've got somebody that I would like to call the guy from Milk and Cereal.
Okay. All right.
Cereal and Milk, or not Cereal and Milk. One of those guys. Chinese Backstreet Boys is what I meant to say. The guy who became a VJ in Taiwan.
Right.
That's who he reminds me of. I would say that his initial profile, it's got a cool style to it, but I would want to say that this is 10 years outdated, even for Taiwan.
Yeah.
This was popping 10 years ago in Taiwan.
Okay.
He said, I go crazy for team building and bonding activities. It's a fun way to get to know each other.
Sounds like a tech guy.
I would probably not say that because that sounds almost like a LinkedIn profile.
Team building and bonding activities.
He has this photo here with chicken lollipops. So I was kind of thinking in my head, maybe he's Nepalese or something. I had never any seen. I just don't feel like chicken lollipops are the go-to food of a lot of girls.
Oh, so he's into the Chinese Indian food. That's the Hakka Chinese food.
Right. He's
the Hakka Chinese. The Hakka Indo food.
He says he loves sports teams, bowling, foodie stuff. And he said, please don't be a serial killer. He has a photo of him doing rock climbing.
No, he said he's not a serial killer. I don't think you need to put that.
You just don't even want to reference serial killers.
Yeah.
This guy says he likes to chill at the aquarium. And then he's got a couple photos right here. Anyway, somebody said, please make the red food photo his default. I just don't even agree with that. Someone says that he also should say long-term only because he had short-term checked as well. And somebody also said that this profile is really meant for coffee meets bagel. Well, because it's more of a nice guy.
Yeah.
You know what I noticed, though? I'll say this. Clearly, this guy's got to be from overseas, and he's, like, come to the West or the Anglosphere, like, more recently. Sometimes... I hate it when people freeze their style to 10 years ago, man. The Jay Chou days is over, man. Stop playing Jay Chou music. Yeah. Like, even Jay Chou's not popping. I mean, he's kind of like a staple, but like, it's not even trending anymore. You know, there's new guys like OZ and everything. Like,
right. How about this, man? How about let's not wear khaki pants when you're rock climbing? Just rock shorts, man. Wear some athletic. This guy's wearing khaki pants while he's at the... Anyways, I don't think he's in bad shape either. I mean, I do think that he seems like a nerdy nice guy, and that's fine if that's who he is. And, you know, he should proceed as that and swipe in different cities. I would recommend him swipe in some big cities and see how it goes.
Or I was going to say, if he's looking for a Himalayan traditional girl, Andrew, isn't he better off playing the IRL system through the temple or the enclave community events?
It's possible.
Yeah, I just think that, you know, it could be a little bit more exciting, a little bit more edgy. Moving on to number four, Andrew, we've got this guy right here. He says, I'm 28 years old and I absolutely get no matches.
Okay, let's take a look at the profile.
He says, choose our first date, ice skating, arcade bar, cooking class. He says, I love ice cream or cold desserts. He works at Accenture. He's actually Hmong.
Oh, shoot, shout out.
He's open and short. He's something for down to travel. He's got this photo with the Sakura. Then this photo's a little bit cooler right here. This photo with his friends chilling in the grass. Not a fan of this photo. Then he said, drinking until 4 a.m., waking until 6 a.m., something I'll never do again. He has an awkward photo with his parents. And then him riding a bike a la the Jay Chou style that I just actually cautioned against just now.
Okay.
This is what people said, Andrew. People said, I don't know, your first photo, you seem like a sad puppy. Do you think that's cool or something? Someone said, you're talking about drunk driving in your prompt stories. I don't like that. Someone said, why post a photo with your parents? Your dad looks like he doesn't even want to be in it with you. Someone said, you're 5'4". Just lie, say 5'7", and get some lifts because 5'4 is automatically getting you killed on the height filter. And I threw this one in there. I said, get a Hmong outfit if you're going after Hmong girls in Minnesota or Fresno.
Yeah.
Yeah, because...
Okay.
Andrew, any thoughts on his profile?
He's got a good smile. I would, remove the parent photo because it's, I'd remove that mirror one where you do the mirror selfie. That bath one where it's actually a good photo of his face, but he does look like a sad puppy. So maybe keep that one though. The one with the friends is cool. Man, just make your height taller. I would say make your height taller, haircut. If you say you like to travel, show some more of the places that you've been that are like landscapey.
Right.
You know what I mean?
I would say show how much money you got, because if you got a good job that's like in the six figures, like do something a little expensive, like just to separate yourself from the broke boys that might be, at least in an American sense,
be perceived as cooler than you. Not that you're rich just because you work at Accenture, but you know, show that you got a sushi dinner. You can afford a sushi dinner. Not saying you should take every girl out to a sushi dinner right away, but you like sushi, okay? I would say
like
that.
Like an omakase, too.
I think this guy's going to date some girls who like food and like nice, like not super nice dinners, but they like food. They're in a like culture. You know, he's Hmong. It's Like, if you know what Hmong is, like, that means the girl's going to be, you know, open-minded or interested in that. So I think that's cool.
Right. Moving on, last but not least, we've got this 24-year-old Asian male living in Silicon Valley. He opens up with the photo with the camo print Canada Goose on. He's, like, in Iceland or something like that. He's 6'2". He's pretty buff, but then he's got some photos in some sort of temple-like community Asian place. He likes pickleball, scuba lessons. He wants to master noodle dishes, get through books, explore. He's got a corgi. And then he's got some like less cooler photos, I would say. I mean, these are fine photos to have taken of you, but just probably not what women are looking for on the apps.
All right, so here's my thing. There's this one slide in his profile that says, "I'll fall for you if you also enjoy aimlessly browsing Wikipedia, trivia games, geography, history, and crossword puzzles." That's a little too honest and a little bit too boring sounding when you're 24. I get it. You are living in Silicon Valley. You're probably very smart. You're
probably a programmer.
You're probably very intelligent. I get it. Shout out to you. You probably make decent money. It's just that that sounds kind of boring to people. So if you're 24 and you want to date other women your age, a lot of other women your age are not like, just shut-ins. You know what I mean? Like, clearly you get out there and you have a boring side and you've done the, decathlon or this Tough Mudder or whatever that is. So that's cool.
Which is physical, but let's be honest, not necessarily the coolest type of physical.
Yeah, it seems like he's kind of an athletic guy who wants a really nerdy girl. So maybe that's who you're looking for. I don't know, but I don't know if this guy really has problems. He's 6'1", so he's going to get matches. I would definitely get a different haircut, though, in my opinion.
He could just switch his location to, like, Vancouver, Canada, or Toronto, and then, like, maybe, like, fly-in chicks or something. Anyway,
No. Change it to Vancouver, BC. You're over on the West Coast. Change it to different parts of the Bay. Change it to Seattle. Change it to LA. Dude, you're on the West Coast. You're not that far.
Somebody said, "I'm not a fan of photos with kids on dating apps." I would agree with that, because there's no point if it's not your kid. And even if it is your kid, you probably want to hide the fact that you have a kid, to be honest, just to increase your pooling. Don't even say anything about your vulnerable side as a prompt. "Bay Area is death for a tech bro, and you especially are into super stereotypical tech bro things like hiking and hot pot." You know what I mean? Like, fitting the archetype.
Sure.
"And why don't you wear a nice shirt in front of some expensive food to let people know that you have money and are willing to spend it?" Because girls will want to know that a guy with a good job that's nerdy is at least living, has some trappings of luxury.
Yeah. Yeah, listen, to me, man, like, parents with your, photos with your parents, I think people think that they're like, yeah, it'll show. I'm like husband material. I'm a good guy. I'm like, yeah. But unless you're trying to catch a wife, I don't think you need it until you're like later in life. Like, I don't think you need to start posting photos of your parents until later in life when you want to like more settle down. Like, just make yourself look cool and interesting. That's all. That's the simplest thing. You don't, I'm not saying you have to go look like a Kevin Wynn. I'm not saying you have to look like a Chad or whatever it is, but you just trying to look as cool, as mysterious and interesting as possible. That's it. That's all.
Right.
That's the main goal.
But it does
right?
have to be an archetype that American women can grasp. In a, like, yeah, but logically I'm assuming in their mind,
these guys are not making this big change. You know, I'm not saying these guys should change exactly who they are, but I'm saying if you don't want to make a drastic change, then that's pretty much the goal of any dating profile.
Right. Anyway, I got some macro takeaways, Andrew. I think in the past, because we grew up in a Chinese church, these guys were like Chinese church guys or Asian church guys, but the Asian church system has somewhat disintegrated over the past decade, I believe. Like, people don't use it as a, it's not a pillar of the community as much as it was.
You could say that there's kind of this edgy inflation, imagery, F-boy inflation.
You're saying the edgy requirement went up.
Yeah, the edgy requirement to look interesting online went up. It's just like everything. It's just like everybody's thumbnails got to get better on YouTube. Everybody's hook in their video. Everybody's cold open got to get better on YouTube. Everybody like has to have hotter girls in their videos to grab attention, just like you grabbing attention on the apps. Gotta look more interesting.
I think that these guys were good kids who listened to their parents and basically fell into the crowd that would accept them, the careers that would accept them. That's good. These are good jobs. They're future proof generally. And I just think that they might have listened to their mom when their mom told them if they did all these things that their dating life would get taken care of. And they might even have white friends in tech or like white coworkers that are into the same things as them that get like way prettier Asian girls than they're getting. But it's just like, as an Asian guy, I feel like the way the game is, it's just not going to work the same as a white tech coworker that's into this same nerdy stuff. Mm-hmm. That's my general lane, just my general thinking. And yeah, I mean, like I said, I think that these guys immediately should like probably go swipe in some other cities, use the whatever, the passport feature or whatever like that, and swipe in some other cities and see if different cities respond to their archetypes differently. Otherwise, do a little bit of work to change the archetype, or at least the perception of the archetype. Mm. Get a haircut. For sure, at least get a haircut. Some new clothes, guys. Anyway, guys, let us know what you guys think in the comments section below. These guys are not getting as many matches as they want, but they're all like on a stats level, good products. What do you guys think they could change? Or should they change? Or what are the societal factors here at play? Let us know what you guys think in the comments section below. Until next time, we the Hot Pot Boys. We out.
Peace.